Grunting in infants can be a worrying sign for patients and caregivers, as it often indicates that a baby is experiencing some form of respiratory distress. This irregular breathing pattern can be caused by various factors, from infection to anatomical abnormalities. Understanding the causes and how to recognize it can help parents and caregivers take appropriate action to ensure that their little ones get the care that they need. And that is the topic of this video. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, infant grunting can be caused by various factors, including infection, anatomical abnormalities, and even normal development. One of the most common causes is a condition known as transient tachypnea of the newborn, or TTN. This occurs when a baby's lungs are not able to clear fluid as quickly as they should after birth. This can lead to difficulty breathing and a characteristic grunting noise. Another common cause of infant grunting is a lower respiratory tract infection, such as pneumonia or bronchiolitis. These conditions can cause inflammation and mucus buildup in the lungs, making it difficult for the infant to breathe. In some cases, grunting may also be a sign of a more serious condition, such as a congenital diaphragmatic hernia. This is a birth defect in which the diaphragm does not form properly, allowing organs from the abdomen to push into the thoracic cavity and restrict lung growth. Recognizing the signs of infant grunting can be challenging, as the noise can be difficult to hear and may not always be present. However, some common signs to look for include rapid breathing, difficulty breathing, flaring nostrils, chest retractions, and cyanosis, which is a bluish discoloration of the skin, particularly around the lips and nails. If you suspect that your baby is grunting or experiencing difficulty breathing, it is important to seek medical attention right away. The doctor will be able to perform a thorough examination and determine the cause of respiratory distress. Treatment for grunting will depend on the underlying cause, but some examples include nasal CPAP therapy, antibiotics for infection, exogenous surfactant in premature infants, oxygen therapy for hypoxemia, and in severe cases, surgery for a congenital diaphragmatic hernia. Expiratory grunting is also one of the factors that determine an infant's Silverman-Anderson index. This is a test that is used to determine an infant's level of respiratory distress by assessing their chest movement, intercostal retractions, xiphoid retractions, nasal flaring, and, of course, their expiratory grunting. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. There should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.